All right, let's talk about adding and subtracting significant figures. So once you've learned how to assign how many sig figs any given number has, the next step is to start using those sig figs in calculations. And we basically have two different rules. There's the rules for addition and subtraction, and there's the rules for multiplication and division. In this video, we'll just be going over the addition and subtraction rules. And so the rule for these guys is that whatever number has the least significant place is how many significant places your answer can have. And so that's also the same as the next rule I'm going to show you guys. But the next one is just if both your numbers have decimals. So if both numbers have decimals, your answer can have the same numbers of decimals that the number with the least has. And with a lot of science and math definitions, even though you kind of have to hear the definition first, I feel like in a lot of ways that can actually be kind of confusing, because both of these just kind of seem like, you know, like science or math circular talking. Like, I don't think they're that helpful. I think you have to hear the definition, then go do the examples, and then the definition slowly starts to make sense. So let's do that right now. And before we start, there's one last thing, which is always how we'll treat sig figs. And that rule is math first, sig figs after. So with all these problems, we're going to do the math first as if we had never heard of sig figs, and then we can go back and look at the rules, and then the way we'll adjust the sig figs is to round to a certain number. So with all that said, let's go to our first example. And so we're going to follow our rule of just doing math first. So first I just add and I get 150.507. Great, so math is done. Now let's apply these sig fig rules. And so in this case, both numbers have decimals, so we can use our pink rule. And so we're just going to have our answer will have the same number of decimal points that the number with the least has, numbers after the decimal. So in this case, 150 only has one after decimal, 180. But 0.507 has 1, 2, 3 after decimal. So in this case, 150 has the least, that's just 1 after the decimal. So that means that we have to round our final answer to 1 after the decimal, because we can only have our answer be as accurate as our least accurate number in our math. And so in this case, we round between these two. There's no rounding up. So our final answer is 150.5. And remember that with all of these examples, in science, we're assuming that 150 and 0.507 are measurements. So in math class, the answer would be 150.507, because we're not thinking in terms of things that were actually measured that had errors or had just inherent limitations to how accurately you could measure them. So sig figs, really just for science, because everything in science is a measurement of some type. All right, so moving along, let's do our next example. Following our rule, we'll do math first, so we get 7.51. And so now we're going to go back and look at sig figs, and not both numbers have decimals in this case, so we're going to follow our first rule, and that's that whatever number has the least significant place is how many significant places your answer can have. So in this case, we've got 4.51, so 4 is in the ones position, 5 is in the tenths position, and then 1 is in the hundredths position. And so 3 only has something in the ones position. So this 3 is the least significant place. It's our least accurate number. We don't really know any decimals that are past 3. So that means that we're going to have to round our final answer right at the ones place, because that's our least significant place. So we have to take this. In this case, we will be rounding up. So our final answer is 8. Let's get my little arrows and box all these guys. All right, and so that's two addition examples. And now let's move on to subtraction. And again, the rule is exactly the same. I just want to show you some variety in practice problems. So first we have 0.854 minus 0.0592. So if you plug that into your calculator, or take a couple seconds to do it, it gets 0.7948. And so now let's look at our numbers. In this case, both of them have decimal places, so we can go ahead and use those. So 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, 4. So in this case, this had 3 after decimal, this had 4 after decimal, and so our answer is going to have 3 places after the decimal. And so even though this counts as 4 after the decimal, this 0 is not a sig fig, remember that, because it's a leading 0. But in this case, it still counts as counting places. So we're going to have to round our number here. We're going to have to cut off in between here for rounding, and we will have to round up. So our final answer is 0.795. All right, and now we just have one more example. And I think in some ways this is the hardest because neither of them have decimal points. So we have to really follow significant places. And so first we're going to do the math like always. So we have 8,500 is our answer. And so now to think about sig figs. So this is a significant place because it is a sig fig. This is a significant place because it also is a sig fig. It's a non-zero. And all three of these zeros don't count as a significant place because they're just placeholders. Since there's no decimal in this number, none of these zeros are sig figs. And so 3,500 is kind of similar. Both of these are sig figs because they're non-zeros, and these zeros don't have a decimal point, so they're not sig figs. So when we think about what's the least significant place, it's really right here. It's in the thousands, because this next one doesn't count, even though the 5 is here, because we need both of our numbers to have something that's significant if we're going to use it in our final answer. So in this case, we'll have to round to the thousands. And so our cutoff will be right here, and we will have to round up. And so our final answer will be just 9,000. And so this is interesting because see how both of these original numbers, 12,000 and 3,500, they have 2 sig figs each. But that doesn't matter because the rule for addition and subtraction is not based on just number of sig figs. So even though both of our answers had 2 sig figs, both of our numbers in the beginning had 2 sig figs, this guy only has 1. And that's completely correct because we just have to pay attention to the place and not the overall number of sig figs. And so that's all I have for you on this topic. I hope you enjoyed it and have a great day. Bye.